Manifold Extrusion. What's up? I'm Jonathan and welcome to Maker Tales, where I'm sharing my maker journey to help you go further in yours. So don't forget to subscribe and hit that little bell icon to never miss an opportunity to keep making. This video is all about extrude manifold and internal faces, because let's be quite frank here. Everywhere on YouTube is saying that extrude manifold is the SketchUp of Blender, and it isn't. Quite frankly, it's a mess. And if you don't know how to use it and how to watch out for the pitfalls of it, it can really muddle you up very quickly. So let's go ahead, let's see how to use it, what it can be used for, and do we even need to use it? Starting with a fresh Blender file, let's go ahead, select everything, delete it, and bring in ourselves a 10mm cube. We're going to talk about extrude manifold, what exactly it is, why it sort of exists, and do you really need to use it, and why is everybody saying this is the new SketchUp way of modeling? Because I can tell you right now, it isn't. So let's go here, right click, subdivide this, and let's subdivide it by about that much. Yeah, let's go to the subdivisions. So extrude manifold is this. A normal extrusion would not let you to do this. However, an extrude manifold would let you do this. But don't get confused, because extrude manifold will not let you do this, go past an edge. However, what it has done is you can select both of these edges and delete them like so, okay? Now you could very much do this with a normal extrusion. And the way that it's done with a normal extrusion is you turn on our auto merging. We also go over to our tools, and we make sure that our auto merge has split edge faces on. And now here, we're gonna do a normal extrusion downwards. Now you can select these faces right here and just delete the faces. There, in a nutshell, is extrude manifold. It's not that special. All it's really done is a couple of operations without you noticing. And the truth is, it can be a bit of a catch, because if you're not truly aware of what extrude manifold does, you might think that you can get away with doing this. Grab this edge, extrude manifold, and drag it to there. You currently have just created yourself a problem, and that is you have an internal face because you've just gone past an edge. If you'd done this the normal way, when I say normal way, it's very limited. Let's go extrude normally, go this way. Remember that we have auto merging on. We have created more geometry here to keep that as a quad, because when we do a manifold, it removes that. And we know that we've just moved over faces. And because we have moved over faces, now let's just do a quick cleanup. We're gonna do a search for interior faces. It's going to select them. And then all you're gonna do is X face delete, because we had these two faces underneath there. All right, now this type of modeling, in essence, I would refrain from, especially when you're doing the rough pass at the beginning, because what you're doing is you're stopping the ability of being able to use your loop selection and loop cut tools. And I would always say, try and use as much as the loop work round and the quad work way, so to speak, till you're happy with the overall shape. Then from there, go limited dissolve and go crazy getting your precision model in place. But remember, you do need to refine it and define every edge, just like we did in the last video. Okay, so that there is extrude manifold. Now don't get confused. Extrude manifold is not SketchUp. If you were to do an extrude manifold and pull this all the way through your cube, it doesn't do what you want it to. I have a feeling they will implement something like that in the future, but not right now. If you're gonna do things like that, just select the face on both sides, do a Control E and do bridge edge loops. And that's going to now bridge that hole right there. Extrude manifold can be very powerful, but it can also be very annoying. Let's see if I can get you to a problem that I had while I was researching for this. Let's create ourselves a cube, 10mm once again, and you would expect that you can select one face, go subdivide, and put in 10 here. Because with an extrude manifold, you should be able to just go here, extrude manifold, pull it down, and it goes great. Okay. So I was thinking this would be a very nice, quick, and easy way to create something like this. We would be able to grab all of these all at once, and then we're going to do a lovely extrude manifold. And things don't always work out. Yes, it can be very powerful, but just keep in mind that I have a feeling that this is quite a work in development. And use it in your own cases with a pinch of salt. Just be aware that it can break things, and to be aware for internal faces. And internal faces, be aware of them whenever, because you could very easily go ahead right now, think that you were selecting all of this here. Then we're going to go and extrude this upwards to here. Well, we've just created a whole bunch of internal geometry there. We have all of these faces now here going crazy. So just be aware, we have internal faces. Grab them, delete them, because they can really screw up your workflow later on in the modeling process when we're using things like modifiers. And that's what I've got to say about Extrude Manifold. I know, it's a little bit of a short video, and quite frankly, it might feel like it's just a throwaway, but in reality, it's quite crucial. All I want to do is give you all the knowledge out there so you can really make your own knowledgeable decision on if you should or should not use Extrude Manifold. I know, quite frankly, I hardly use it at all, because I find that I get more problems when I'm using Extrude Manifold than any other tool in Blender. Anyway, a huge thank you to my patrons. You guys are absolutely awesome, and it's the reason why I can make these videos right here. And if you're enjoying the videos that I'm making here and you think I'm worthy of your support, I would love to see you there too. Don't forget that we have a Discord, and that's linked down in the description. Thank you for watching, keep making, and let the quest continue.